Hello and welcome to another Triplo AI video. Today, I have the pleasure to present you the amazing new features that we released with version 3.4 and 3.2 of Triplo AI for desktops. So without further ado, let's start with hotkeys. The hotkeys feature is just an amazing new feature that we just released, and I'm going to tell you why. The key thing here is that hotkeys allows you to prompt AI with or without smart prompts in a very good and fast fashion. To set up your hotkeys, you have to jump into Triplo AI settings and then find hotkey settings under customizations. And there you see fields to add a new hotkey. So the first one I'm going to add is Control Tab, and I'll associate it with improve, which is one of the smart prompts that I use the most. And I'll also add another hotkey, control backspace, and this I'll associate to no smart prompt. So this will be a different way of prompting, and I'm going to show you how to do it. So let's get back to Triplo AI, and I have this LibreOffice writer. And here I'm going to write a misspelled phrase. So let's say, so I wrote in very bad English. I love speaking in English, but I'm Brazilian. And all I need to do now is select this whole phrase and hit Control Tab. And then you hear the Triplo AI pop, and it will replace the original sentence with the reviewed and improved one. So I enjoy speaking in English, even though I'm Brazilian. So this is an example, and it's equivalent for someone using the old method of prompting, triple O, imp, and then the sentence. So you are triggering AI with this improve smart prompt applied to the sentence that you have selected. But it's much easier using hotkeys. So now let me show you what happens when you use these hotkeys without associating it to a smart prompt. So let me write something here, a prompt. I just wrote, suggest me a 3-day trip plan to Istanbul with kids and elders. And all I need to do is select this whole phrase and hit Control Backspace, which is my hotkey without association to a smart prompt. And we'll wait for a bit. The first pop sound already ringed. And let's wait a little more. This is more complex. And there we have it. So we have a full 3-day trip plan for Istanbul, traveling with family, so kids and elders, including historical highlights and food and Bosphorus and cultural experiences and so on and so forth. So this is a very, very efficient way for you to prompt AI without even need to jump into Triplo AI interface. I'm really loving it. You should try it now. Let's talk about files. You asked for files management and prompting for a while. And let me tell you why this is so important. Because sometimes you need files to be to serve as context, and even images now we can process. We added images to Triplo AI in this version, and you can extract information from these images and use them directly into your prompt. There are two different ways that you can do it. And I'll show the first one. The first one, I just pinned my interface on the screen just for the sake of simplicity. You can jump into a directory and select one file. So in this case, I have this sample contract. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to run legal, one of our smart prompts, into this contract. And when I hit enter, you see that it will process the full smart prompt on this particular document, and it will extract the key points of the contract, legal risks for each one of the parties, and that's it. So it worked perfectly. You could, for example, activate your chat mode here and keep talking to it. So I could ask something like, I ask it, what are the penalties for a party that decides to cancel the contract? And then Triplo AI is listing what are the penalties. You got it. You can ask things about your documents, your text documents, or even images. So let me show you an example of an image prompt. So let's me ask something like, suggest me a blog post for, and then I'll insert an image of a group of people sitting around the table and like, I believe, celebrating some job well done. And then I hit enter, and there we have it. The power of collaboration, embracing diversity in business marketing. And then you have this, I believe it's a good draft of a blog post based on this image. And let me show you the image so you have a better idea of what I'm talking about. This is the image of people together, working together, well-dressed, with computers and so on. And you can use this with even with print screens. So now I'm going to simulate, because I don't have a good print screen here, but I have blue screen of death of Windows, and I'll ask, how can I sew this? And then I'll drop this image into my Triplo AI. And then it will process the image, extract the content, and try to find a good solution for this particular Windows error. So it's pretty simple, pretty straightforward, very easy to use. And all you have to do is insert images and text files into your prompts and take advantage of them. Now let's jump into another new feature of Triplo AI. Let's talk about training. So we improved the way you built your minds. And the importance of it, of this new training feature, is that it's easier for you to build minds using not only files, so multiple files at the same time, or multiple links or URLs at the same time. So what I did, I jumped into this training setup screen, and I'll name this new training Triplo Docs, for example. But I need the links, so I'll head back to my Triplo AI and documentation, and I'll do a little trick here. I'll scrape HTML, the documentation, and then I'll have the full content of my documentation, and then I'll use extract raw URLs. I have a smart prompts for that, and it will list all of my all of the URLs linked to this HTML. So there you go. We have a list of links that I have on my documentation. And let's wait a bit for it to end. And cool. Now I'm going to copy all of the relevant ones and head back to my training. And I'll create this Triplo doc. And I'll just need to click on this links icon and paste the URLs and click on the green arrow. And you see all of these all of these URLs being parsed, and the mind will be full of Triplo AI's whole documentation. So let's wait a bit. Sometimes it takes a while. But there we have it, 32,000 tokens. And I'll save this mind. It may take up to 10 minutes for it to process. Let's hope it's faster. Okay, so now we have Triplo Doc, and I'll activate this mind. It's the last one. Okay, so now I have Triplo Doc here. And if I ask something, for example, how can I set a new admin device on my license, and hit enter, it will go through the content of all of those URLs, extract the relevant information, and then present it back to me. So I have this full mind of Triplo AI's full documentation ready to be used, for example, to answer support questions. As I mentioned, you could also train your minds using files, and you can add like multiple files at once. So let's say you have like 10 PDFs or whatever you want to add, just respect the limits to 100,000 tokens, but it should be good enough for a great deck of files. Cool. So moving on, let me share with you something really interesting. I don't know if you notice it, but we are much more dynamic now, adding new models to Triplo AI. Happens that before the version 3.4.0, we needed to release new versions, new clients, to add new models and remove the old ones. Now we are doing this on the server side, so it's much easier for us to keep up to date with new models being released like every week. We'll do our best to add these models, but if you need a particular model from OpenRouter or even on your API keys, just drop us a message and we'll add it to the list, okay? Let me check what I'm missing. Okay, we have a very simple but useful thing. We added the capability of whenever you're setting a new smart prompt, you can add tags to it. So I have this, let's say, I have this YouTube Felipe, I don't know what's that. And this is related to YouTube, and I could add another tag. So say, let's say, Triplo AI. And then whenever I'm working on these smart prompts, I can filter them for their tags. So here I have everything that I have related to YouTube. And I could add another tag and search for, let's say, Amazon. And I have smart prompts related to Amazon. We are like touching this organization side of Triplo AI. This should expand to other custom features and like minds and automations and stuff. It's just the first step, but it's a good one. And now let me show you another new feature. You asked us to be capable of sharing custom smart prompts and instructions and automations and minds, but also allowing other devices under your license to edit them. And you can activate it now. If you want to do that, just head to your settings and then device management. And under your device, you'll see what you can sync and if you want to allow other devices in the same license to edit them. So it works on desktops for now. I know some of you are looking forward the same features on mobile. As you know, mobile comes a little later than desktop. We prioritize desktops when developing. Soon you'll have it on your mobile phones also. And if I got it right, that's all. Be sure, we are very, very happy with this release, mostly because it packs lots of features that you asked us during these later months. And we are kind of impressed with your reaction and your engagement. And also, you know, I am probably the one that uses Triplo AI the most. And I'm really impressed with some of these features. So I hope you enjoy. Take care. Bye-bye.